A Kantech ioSmart reader's firmware can be updated through a connected controller, such as a KT1. However, there may be situations where you wish to update several readers prior to deployment, or when you are performing a panelist deployment and do not have a controller. This video will walk you through performing a firmware update to the ioSmart reader without a controller. To do this, you will need an RS-485 output device, such as the Kantech USB-485 module. This device connects to your PC's USB port and provides RS-485 output terminals to connect to the terminals on the back of the ioSmart reader. You can also achieve this with many third-party USB and RS-232 to RS-485 converters on the market. Log in to the Kantech website and expand the support menu to select software downloads. From the software downloads page, click to expand door controllers and readers, then select ioSmart. Download the latest ioSmart Reader firmware, as well as the ioSmart Reader firmware upgrade tool. When downloaded, extract the ioSmart Reader firmware from the zip file. If your PC has an RS-232 connection and you are using an RS-232 to RS-485 converter, you may connect this now. If you are using a USB to RS-485 converter, plug in the USB connection now. You will need to locate the COM port your PC has assigned to the device. Click the Windows Start button and search for Device Manager. Within Device Manager, expand the ports, COM and LPT node. You can usually pinpoint the device by name if it says USB to serial in the name. If you are unsure, you can watch which device appears or disappears while connecting and disconnecting the USB device. When you've located it, make a note of the COM port shown. In our example, this is COM4. Now you will need some spare wire to make the connections between the converter and the reader. You can use some spare Cat5 network cable or pieces of low voltage jumper wire. If using the Kantech USB 485 module, connect the X positive terminal to the D1 X positive terminal on the back of the reader, and the X negative terminal to the D0 X negative terminal on the reader. If using a third-party converter, the terminals will likely be labeled TX positive and TX negative. You will need to provide 12 volts DC power to the reader as well, since the serial connection does not power it. Find a 12 volt DC power source and connect the positive wire to the power terminal on the back of the reader. Connect the ground or negative wire to the ground terminal on the reader. The reader will beep when powering on. It will beep several times if it is in default mode. Locate the ioSmart Reader firmware upgrade tool you downloaded and run it. If running the application for the first time, you may receive some warnings that the defaults file is missing. This is fine. Just click OK to continue. The program will create the file for you. When the application window appears, use the drop-down at the top to select the COM port you made a note of from the Device Manager earlier. Test the connection by clicking the Get Firmware Version button. If wired correctly, this should return the version information of the firmware currently running on the ioSmart reader. To perform an update, click the Firmware Upgrade button. Navigate to the folder created when you extracted the firmware from the downloaded zip file and select the file with the bin file extension. When you click the Open button in the dialog, the firmware update will begin immediately. You will see the sent number of bytes displayed. When finished, the application will display a success message. You can then close this window, and the reader will restart. Wait for the beep letting you know it has restarted. The firmware upgrade is now complete.